Test. Okay. All right. Whew. All right. How is everybody? Happy Tuesday. Oops. Prop. Oh, let me get your mic going.
There how the sausage is made.
Yeah. Okay, I don't know how much I missed the 10-minute marker. I'm sorry about that. I'm feeling red.
What color tonight? Oh my.
Yeah, you
matchy,
think?
Matchy.
What do you think? Orange is better?
Ooh.
Maybe
I don't
the
know.
Red with the red is too
Ooh.
Much. Yeah. Let's.
I like it.
Yeah.
Bold.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
I had this hair in like junior high school.
You had what?
I had this hair in junior high school, except it was shaved up here.
Oh.
Yeah, I had white walls, actually. That was a real bad
the
moment
flop
in my
bang.
Relationship
you had
with
the
my
flop
orange.
Bang.
Sweet. Thanks, Jackie. Okay, so I want to tell you about my day. I have not been feeling good all day, and I haven't been feeling good for a while, and it's not like depression, it's like physically feeling bad, and I have been basically laying around, which I never do, all day today, and I really was thinking about canceling the class, and I know you guys would have been fine with that. But Anne had already committed to coming, and I just had this sense that I should follow through on this. And so I woke up from a nap and started setting up, and I just ran a little bit late. And I have to tell you that I'm in a great mood right now. Like, this is the best that I have felt all day. And whether it's adrenaline or you guys or being with Anne or whatever it is, I feel great. So I'm so
Class
glad that
Class
you
were all.
Patient and we could start 5 minutes late so I could get this all set up, because I am so happy to be here. And I feel amazing now. So with that said, we're going to talk about balance tonight or today.
Nice.
And this is going to be pretty much balance the whole class. And so this may not be the type of class for everybody. I mean, we'll see what happens. I mean, we're going to talk transitions too, hopefully, if I remember. But we're basically going to be working a lot on balance. Your arms are probably going to be tired at the end of this. I think balancing is great. I balance on the back of my hand or any other point. I hardly ever do my palms. You can do your palms. So of course, Tiana was a great balancer. She taught at Hoop Path on the Hoop Path stage, and she taught on the palm. So I'm totally like, it's not like it's a rule. I just like the way it looks. That's really the whole reason I started doing it. Some people think it's easier. So, you know, whatever, however your arms are built. But I'm going to be doing it on the back of my hand tonight. Usually when you see somebody doing it on the back of the hand, they probably have some kind of Hoop Path connection, but not always. Times change, and of course people could do it anyway without ever knowing about me.
I'm a proud backhander.
And do you have any thoughts on balance or anything you want to say before we – I really want to hit my four-minute mark here.
I do. I love the back of the hand, but I love the contrast of the feeling of the palm. And I loved what Tiana would do would be to go back and forth. And that's really neat when you can push up and you know, switch. That's a, you know, kind of an extra Olympic level move, but it's really fun. If you've been balancing a long time, push from the back of the hand to the palm and by pushing up into the fingers. Yeah, but anyway, tonight's going to be fun. I love balance.
Okay. Well, let's go ahead and get started then. I want to hit some things, cuz sometimes I forget that beginners are watching here, and I want to make sure that people know. Some people think that a heavier hoop is easier to balance. It's like the bigger contact balls are actually feel a little bit easier to hold. So this may not necessarily be a small hoop thing, but kind of like core hooping balance, you can have sort of a sweet spot. But here's the thing. Once you learn balance, you can do balance anything. Like, people can balance a wheelbarrow. It doesn't matter what what kind of shape your hoop is in, whether it's perfectly round or anything like that. anything can be balanced. And so what you're developing is not how to balance the hoop. You're learning how to balance anything. Like in you know, there's loads of examples of ways you could do this, balancing bottles and all sorts of things. So we're going to sway up. I've already got things loaded. So hopefully this will behave. And I'm going to guide this sway a little bit because of what we're doing with point. This one might be too, this is kind of a fast point. Should we, what do you think? Should we start with the fast point or? No, that's a little too fast. We'll make that the second song. Yeah, we will slow sway. Yeah, here we go. All right. I'm sorry I didn't read off all the names, y'all. I just wanted to, since we were starting late, I just kind of knew some people have to be places. Audible breath in. A switch there. I like this better. Audible breath in. Audible breath in. Balancing the hoop, it can be helpful to visualize energy coming up from your feet, through your legs, through your body, and into your hands and your arms. It may not make sense at first, but a lot of your success in balancing is how well you use your feet. Is that your feet already know how to move. They just need awareness. You don't have to tell them to do anything. You just become aware of them. Audible breath in. So I invite you to feel energy coming up through the hands. Balancing the hoop on our hands tonight, but the energy is going to come from the whole body. Audible breath in. Thank you. song, I invite you to make slow, gooey contact with one hand, either on another arm or on the body, but making contact. You can even do it with the back of your hands if that's where you want to balance. I invite you to move the back or the palm around the surface of your skin, imagining that you're waking it up. Balance is a sense of touch. We can imagine that we feel like we listen better when we try, that we see differently when we squint. Tonight we're working with heightened touch. Open, open, open. All right. Okay, leave this song on in the background.
When I was doing the touching, you know, the tracing exercise with my own hands on my own body, I was really finding the, you know, the moving parts, like the moving joints, feeling my foot go up and down, my ankle, my knee, feeling my calf. That was really amazing. Totally amazing. Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. I was totally feeling the breathing on that last one for me. Okay. Song in mind. There it is. Okay. Okay, so we're going to get into balance now. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start with low stakes. Oh, hey, Rita. I should be reading these comments. Great sway. Sweet. So we're going to. There we go. Okay. Sorry. I'm going to make one little adjustment there. Anne loves to wear green, so she's kind of blending in tonight. Okay, so we're going to start off with working on balance by, you know, you think you had it all right, and then boom. By holding the hoop, just hanging it instead of balancing it. So this is hanging point. This is what we did our last class on. And for this next exercise, we're going to start with hanging point. Because there are some things you can do with it that are just easier than trying to do it in balance, although you can do a lot of them in balance. So to start, I invite you to hold the hoop by the top two corners. That's if you threw a square into the hoop where those corners would meet. If I push the hoop out, it makes a third point of contact. Audible breath in. Now, in balance, you're not going to be feeling the hoop resting on the core. So if you like that feeling, this song would be a good chance to feel into that. And by that I mean if you like the gooey touch. But I invite you to keep a point hand or whatever surface you think you're going to use to balance. Because this exercise, we're trying to open open up the surface of whatever's going to be holding the hoop up. Audible breath in. Now for this next one, this next layer, you're just going to have to trust me. We're going to get the heart rate up while doing this. And we're going to do it by lowering, raising, balancing, big stepping, whatever it is. Because for balancing all class, we want to be warm. Audible breath in. When the hoop is off the body, one way I can develop moving my forearms is just to do these like simple little foldy moves here. That you can warm up the back of the hand is kind of like the move we were doing in the last class, but I'm just keeping the hoop on my hand or wherever I'm going to be balancing, and I'm just folding it on that point. When I have the hoop on the back of my hands, I can start to swing the hoop. This is an arm workout. I don't want to burn your arms out on too much, but one cool little circuit that you can do is I'm swinging the hoop straight out, and then I can kind of do this sort of step to the side swing it out. Get kind of higher, you know, with my swings. I can be like the little kid on the swing that gets higher and higher. I can swing and hop through it. If you got a high enough ceiling like I do. My hands, however they do, are going to go up into the hoop, and I'm going to drop my core. So I'm going to, right? So I'm here. It's going to be almost like I'm spreading a blanket or something, right? Like I'm spreading a sheet onto a bed. I'm going to swing it out and then duck my hands so I can... When I make that swing out, I'm catching the hoop. I'm keeping it from hitting my head. This is going to sound hippie, with my eyeball gaze energy. When I swing it out, I am locking in on a point. I'm picking the north point here, and I'm locking in, and I'm just using all of my, you know, imagination to see this, like, vision hand holding the hoop there. So I swing it out. Now, what I recommend is that you don't look at your hands. A lot of times when you're trying to do this, you'll look at your hands. I think it's easier to look up away from your hands. I don't look at my hands at all. You, believe it or not, you can trust your hands. By this point in the game, your hands probably know what to do without you telling it. If you're having a situation where the hoop just won't go vertical, that means that you need to lower. So as I swing the hoop out, see how my hands are on the top? We need them to get to the bottom. And to make that journey, we need like some momentum. So I swing out and I drop, and that's, there you go. All right, we'll practice some of this. Now, for those of you that can do that, so I'll show you how this, we were talking about transitions in the last class. So let's say I'm going from this little swing thing here, like I like it or whatever, and then I can go into the balance from there. And then to get out of a balance, I can swing it. This is if I made like a balance circuit. Well, sort of. So when I'm swinging it out, I'm keeping it on the back of my hands, but you could swing it out and put it on the palms. If you're using your palms, just, you know, be careful to not let your grip slow down your balance learning, right? Like, gripping the hoop is not balancing it. Now, once I'm up there, if I can't make the move, you can just do something like this, where you bring your hands, palms up, pinky to pinky, and you just roll over, right? So I'm here. Now when I make the roll over, I'm looking at the hoop already. I'm focused in on the hoop. My eyes are crossing because I'm so focused in. And then I turn my palms up to it. Now for those of you, I know that we have a wide range of skill sets that show up. We have a wide range of skill sets that show up in here. If you're, you know, if you can do this dayside balance, ready to start putting it on wheels if you don't already, or raising and lowering, really starting to test the sturdiness of the balance. So if I, like, you know, if I'm swinging out, okay, and I'm in day and I'm feeling pretty locked in, then I might like lift a leg. Of course, I'm always trying to be as still as I can, but you know, sometimes we're not perfect. Or I can raise and lower. And sometimes you can find your balance sort of grip by raising and lowering. That's pretty good. Oh wait, this isn't what I want to listen to. I don't want to listen to that, sorry. I wasn't right, I thought we were good. There is, let's see, is it playing? Yeah, okay. And then we're not going to spend all the night on this, but also for those of you that have some flight time with this, you can do the one-point swing. Oops. Of course, I'm not going to be able to do it on live TV. Well, it used to be better. All right. What? just long blink. Sure, yeah, yeah, totally. Okay, so let's go back. If you're really struggling, like you're really frustrated and you can't keep this up, then go ahead and turn to the palms if you need to. But one thing that really helps in your balance is managing to keep some bend in your arms so that you're not holding, we're not like perfectly straight with our arms, but that they're bent, right? And that can really make a big difference. I'll show you what I'm talking about. If I'm out here and I'm in this dayside balance again, like it, maybe it looks cool to have my arms fully extended, but the balance is so much more stable if I bring in my elbows. And like Shelly wrote in the comments, my elbows are high. See how they're coming out? No, the height of my hands can also, like, maybe for some of you, that this is the height. Some people like to do this thing, like, where they kind of, like, just bang the hoop back into balance with their head. Whatever. But change your height. If you're struggling with one, and, you know, if you really can't do the swing out, then just, you know, just roll the hands over. Like, maybe you get it when it's way up high. Maybe you need to have it down here. And we're going to move into bow balance. I'll give you just a couple, a minute or two to. What? And then we'll move on. If I'm in this balance here, well, we're going to move into bow balance next, but if I'm in this balance, sometimes people would ask me, like, well, how should I hold my hand? Like, what should it be doing? You can spread it out to create a lot of surface area, but I promise, once you get the balance, like, once you get balance, you can hold the hoop anywhere you want to, and I'll demo this by saying that, like, I'm here, and I'm rolling out, and right now, I don't know if you can see because of the quality of the video, but my fingers are spread out, and I can actually drum my fingers, and the hoop is staying balanced, right? Like, each finger I'm trying, you know, to basically do a bunch of little hops. You can also just, you know, this is one trick, balancing on a first knuckle, like something like this, so I'm not, see how it's on the side of my hands? Nice hand. Choppy, got a good balance. Okay. If your arms are starting to feel tight, give them, you know, a little bit of a massage if you need it. We're going to move into, go ahead, Anne. You have something to say?
I wanted to say I was really trying to challenge myself. I do a lot of this kind of, you know, horizontal back of the hand balancing, and I was trying to do a perpendicular by the swinging, you know, because the swinging puts you in a perpendicular balance, which is why, you know, the theoretically the 2-point should be a little easier, although I find both of them equally difficult, the swing up. And it's this huge challenge for me, but I really had fun doing it.
Sweet mantra. Yeah. Yeah, turning your hands, Shelly's. Yeah, these are good comments. I'm glad you please post if you have any progress tonight, please post. All right. So the next balance we're gonna try is gonna be a balance that sometimes people get before they get the dayside balance, and a lot of people like this one better for whatever reason. But maybe it's because you can do a lot with it. But this is what it's called. I'm holding it on the back of my hand, and even though it's not the best name in the world, we call this the bow side balance. And basically all it means is that, you know, it's in parallel, well, I guess it's perpendicular to your shoulders. it's parallel with the, you know, to your fingers, to the wall to the right of you or left of you, whatever. Now, you can create surface area for this balance by bringing your fingers together, and you'll hold the hoop somewhere in this channel. Now, Anne's doing it a different way. That's fine. What I don't want to talk you out of the successful way, but if you struggle, you can lay the hoop like right here. But you don't want to. Oh gosh. All right, we'll try this. I wasn't planning on. This song is kind of disco-y, and I'm not sure it's going to be perfect here. Actually, this is not going to be good. No, it's a good song, but yeah, no, it just turns into kind of like a disco song, and I think it's not going to be maybe the best thing for us right now. Okay, so let's try this balance. Now, when I'm holding this balance, if I'm putting it down my fingers, or, you know, like put it in the groove, I'm going to bend my arm. I don't recommend learning like this. You can balance like this, of course. You can do anything. But I recommend putting a bend in my arm. So instead of this. Now, some people like to look at the space of this piece of hoop right in front of their face. That's too intense for me. I like to look across the hoop. So when I'm talking about that visual hold, I'm holding it here with my eyes. So I'm here, and then the moment that I bear, like the moment the hoop is supposed to be in balance, I'm locked in on that. Now when my arm gets tired, if you're ready, you can do a pass to the next hand. And if you're gonna do that pass to the next hand, you can start by coming into 2 point. I mean, one way you can do it is I'm on 1 point. I can go into 2 point and then just roll the hoop down. Although that didn't work too good. Actually, rather than roll it, I would just come up under it. It's still gonna roll a little bit, but. Of balance is your arm strength. It gets stronger. That's why your balance gets better. Your arms get stronger at doing this. And if you are a workout nerd or whatever and you want to speed this up, you can add raising and lowering to any of the balances and it'll speed up the process. So I'm here in the balance. I'm holding it. And then I can just come down and up and down and up. Squats, that's murder. I'm looking straight across, Shanna. Yeah, that's what I was saying in sway, that, you know, you're really holding the hoop with your push up from your feet. Even if your arms are starting to get tired, think about, I'm using my legs. You can almost just make your arm just, you know, the least responsive part if the feet are going. And then from there you can, so what happens, you learn a balance in one part, wherever you learn first, and then you move how to learn that balance, or you move that sense of touch up or down the arm if you want to. So this is me holding the hoop on my, balancing it on my fingers, right? This is me rolling to the, I think I've had one too many Diet Cokes tonight. This is me balancing it on the back of the hand. This is the wrist, forearm. And so you can develop that touch by just rolling it forward or backward. Yeah, okay, so the reason you want the hoop to roll back towards you, well, not obviously, but it's helpful because that's where you are. And so what I'm doing is I'm always erring when I'm holding the hoop this way, however it's happening, I'm always erring on pushing this way. So like my hand, instead of just going up and down this way, it tilts, it moves, right? So If I tilt it down, the hoop's going to roll that way. If I bring it back, the hoop is going to roll towards me. So if you bring your fingers up, one move that you can try that's kind of cool to develop your sense. I've got the hoop on the back of my hand, and I can give it just a little paddle, and it's rolling. I don't know if you saw that or if I was too janky with it, but here. So I'm holding it here. I can just give it just a little paddle. Oop, that one didn't work. Give them a little paddle. Sounds kind of weird. Hold it on the left hand. I don't know if you guys see what I'm doing, but and these are axle spins. Yeah, once you know, it's like this is an exercise. I think I've shared this before. You know, I don't know if ADD is real. I feel like if it is, I have it. And this exercise, like learning to balance, really helped me in the real world because of focus. You know, like a lot of the balance is achieved by just an intense focus on the point of contact or the stair point or whatever you want to call it. Just staying locked in on that. Okay, I'm going to go 5 minutes later, so we're going to end at 8:05. Like, that will be the end of class. End of, the green screen will come up at 8:05. But there's a few things I still want to work on, if you have it in you. Nice, Anne. Nice. Nice. That was good. I don't know. I hope you guys could see what she was doing there. She had a little pose going and some balance. If I want to... Oh, well, what I was going to say... Oh, go ahead, Andy. You want to say something?
Well, I was going to just explain that I was challenging myself in these, which I have been doing a lot more of, and I'm better at these bow balances. And so I was trying to do foot balances and hoop balances at the same time.
Nice, nice. They look good. Okay. Okay, so I want to add just a few more things, and you guys have been great. I don't know who's been able to stick around. again, this is a super tech class, but these are things that I think can help. So if you are having any kind of success with this balance and you're ready to sort of add more to it, you can start to teach your hand how to catch a hop. Yeah. Yeah, I may have had the chat set up wrong. Sorry, y'all. Or it might be a resolution issue. But anyway, so I'm holding the hoop here, and I can throw it up and catch it. You can do this with two hands. So this is 2-point. We haven't really talked about this yet. Actually, this might be a good one to end on. This is 2-point, so I'm here, and like I was telling Jennifer about tilting your hand back, I'm holding the hoop, it's running down my fingers here, and I tilt the hand back, and it's gonna roll right towards my face, and then this is 2-point. If I push up a little bit and turn my hands, I can fold the hoop. So I'm here in 2-point. Now this time I'm looking at the north point right now because it's the one that's not going to change. So I'm looking up there at the top on this move. So I'm here and I'm going to kind of push up with my hands just to make it light and then switch over, and I've just folded the hoop. And instead of looking across, I'm looking right there because that's the one that doesn't move. So I'm here and I'm going to push up just to make it light. You know, if that push up is throwing you off, don't do it. what's happening on... Oops. Oh, I see. What's happening on this move and on this move here is you're teaching your hand how to feel. This is not that easy. Yeah. All right. Maybe we'll call it a class after this. But what you're developing, it's basically like you first, or for me anyway, I first learned to hold it this way. And then when I wanted to try to, I had to develop like the sense of touch that nothing was going wrong if the hoop starts to, what would you call that? Pirouetting? What would you call that? I don't know. So watch my hands here. And do you see how they're pointing in opposite directions? So I'm on this side of the hoop, and they're in opposite directions. So one's pointing this way to the hoop, and one's pointing this way to the hoop. When I make this switch, those hand positions are going to change. And so what has to happen is as the hoop is spinning, it is making contact like that. It's staying on your hand. It's like this sort of gooey, nice, sort of this gooey roll across. Sometimes it's easier just to hand walk it than it is to go back and forth, honestly. This is what it looks like sort of as a hand walk. Some of you are wishing that maybe I hadn't taught class. All right, we'll talk about. Ann says we should do the axle spin again some more time to take that in. Okay, so maybe I pushed too hard and added a little bit too much. Sweet. Okay, let's just free hoop a little bit. You can either work on that stuff or not, or see if you can add transitions into it. Again, when you're doing balance, you're not doing it for a whole hour like we just did. We just gave yourself, your arms a real workout. So this will be our free hoop, and then we'll call it a night. Yeah, I never was able to.
There's a limit to your love. Like a waterfall in slow. Like a map with no ocean. There's a limit to your love. There's a limit to your care. Yeah. Is it truth or dare? Is it truth or dare?
Sweet. Thank you guys. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Really appreciate it. Unless I feel horrible, we will definitely have class on Saturday at noon. May do a core challenge or some kind of workout class. Yeah. Well, I hope you heal up quick, Jackie.
There's a limit to your love. Like a waterfall. Like a map with no ocean. There's a limit to your love. Thank you.
Yeah, Jennifer. That's a great comment. Thank you, Lindsay. Have a great night.
Fruitful balance for me. I feel centered. Thanks,
okay,
Bax.
You got it. Sweet. You guys have a great night, and I'll see you Saturday.